Hi there, we're going to talk about member permissions in a team environment. So right now you're looking at the member permissions area of my health and safety team. I'm going to back out of here and make sure you know how to get in here, and then we're going to go through each of these permissions together. So how I got to this point was I clicked on the health and safety team on the left here, went to the three dots, went to manage team. From manage team, I went over to settings. And from settings, I have member permissions. So our first permission we have to consider for this particular team is whether we want our members to create and update the channels. So I'm going to just refresh your memory on channels. If I click on the team health and safety, the channels I have currently are general, compliance, HS training, and risks and hazards. So do I want them to create more channels under this team? And do I want them to update that channel by, there's three dots beside each channel, so there's some settings within each channel that I can allow them to have access to. So that's an on or an off switch right there. So if I don't want them to change the way I've structured this team and add any more channels or change any of the ones I have, then I would turn this off. Let's start with that. So the next option though, which is kind of interesting to me that it wasn't already classified as off, is the fact that if I said I didn't want them to create channels, that I probably don't want them to delete a channel. It's not assuming that for me, so if I don't want that to happen, they shouldn't be just deleting any of my channels that I already have created or any channels that are created by anybody, and restoring any channels that have been deleted. I have to uncheck that box. I'm going to go back up to allowing my members to create or edit channels and just want you to see the private one. So maybe I want them to create channels, but I don't want them to create any private channels. So that would be an option that maybe you turn off instead of that top one. Okay, at this point, I'm just going to leave all three of these off. I don't want my members creating or changing or deleting or restoring any channels. So what I'm saying is I've created the team and I like the channels the way they are and nobody needs to change them. Okay, the next option for permissions is allowing members to add or remove apps. The next four permissions in this list are related to the same kind of thing. So I'm going to just remind you of where the apps actually sit and where the tabs are. So allow members to add or remove apps. Let's just go out of the settings here and let's go back to the channel. So at the top of every channel on the right side here, I have the plus sign. When I hit the plus sign, that's allowing me to add an app. So as a member, should I be hitting the plus sign in that channel? And really, it is for the whole team. So that means in any of the channels of this team. So I can go to any channel. I always have a plus sign. Do I want my membership to have access to adding more apps onto that channel? So think for a minute in terms of how this team is set up. Is the team set up really well and it's really has everything that membership of the team needs as far as channels and as far as applications? Or did you just have kind of the bare bones set up here for them where they have the channels but you haven't really given them a lot of extra things in the channel as in the apps? So if you haven't put in a lot of apps at the top of the channel, you might want to leave this open for them to discover and decide which applications make sense to add to that channel. But again, depending on your membership size, if you have lots of members, you're saying you're allowing this to happen with any member. So you decide whether that flexibility for your membership is required or needed based on what you've created for them for a team and a channel system. So I'm going to close out of that. So add or remove apps. I'm going to leave mine on so I can allow my membership to hit that plus sign and add more things to the team. So examples of apps, by the way, are OneNote, Planner, Lists, and there's about 500 more options out there. The next option is similar. Allow members to upload custom apps. So within the team's environment, people can customize applications. And so that's what you're saying here is that you've had a custom application available to you. Do you want your membership to be able to upload that custom application into the channel of the team? Allow members to create, update, and remove tabs. So this refers to that same area. So I'm just going to go out of here and remind you of what I'm referring to. So tabs are the names given to the area at the top when you add an app. Posts, files, and wiki come with every single channel of every single team. the first two posts and files are always going to be there. You can't change them in any way or remove them. The third one, the wiki, is available to you to rename. So I'm just going to click on wiki here and hit the arrow. I can rename it or I can even remove it. So with that permission for my membership, I'm allowing them to have that option. So for this particular tab, they also, if I'm allowing them to make changes to the tabs, I could have them click on a tab that exists. So health and safety is a tab that's brought in here because of a health and safety notebook. This is a OneNote notebook that was added to this channel. If I let them edit the tabs, they can go to this drop down here and they can remove it from the channel. They can rename it. Those are the main changes that they can make. So depending on how well my team is set up for the information at the top of the channel, like those tabs at the top, if I know it is all set up in such a way that I have everything everybody needs and it's well described at the top of those tabs, then I might not want them to have the ability to create, update, or remove those tabs. And by the way, when my team is very new to the Teams environment and discovering stuff, I might turn this off. I might turn a lot of these off just to protect them from making changes and then getting confused because, oh, I don't have that on top of my team, or where did it go? This way you're protecting the team from any accidental changes by members that maybe are not used to clicking around in it. Allow members to create, update, and remove connectors. So connectors is similar to apps. Connectors are a specific type of application that actually communicate with the Teams environment. So there's a lot of sample connectors available when you say add an app. So an example of a connector that I'll give you that I have on one of my teams is Microsoft Forms. So one of the forms I have available is an assessment on people's skill level with any of the Microsoft products. And so once someone fills in that form for me, then that filled in form link is sent to the channel. So then I know with looking at the channel, hey, someone filled in my form, I can click on the link, it takes me right to the form. So that's a connector. Do we need members to create these connectors, update these connectors, and remove these connectors? So again, probably if I put a connector in place as the team owner, maybe don't want people changing them or removing it. So that might be one thing we turn off. Give members the option to delete their messages. And so the one right underneath it, just so you're aware, is the option to edit their messages. So again, it depends on that group of people that you have as membership. Let's just go to where messages are and just see what these two things mean. So if I go to my channel here for general, not a lot of messages in this particular channel, but I have one that actually, if you notice, this message has been deleted. So this member that was visiting this channel was able to delete the message. This message here, if you notice, new message from Connie Clark says it was edited. So this member has the ability to delete and edit messages. I'm just going to go to a different channel. So in the compliance channel, I want to just show you where this delete and edit is. So I'm going to go to the three dots above a message. And as a member, I have the ability to delete this message that's posted in the channel. That, by the way, will not delete that document that was included in the message. That document would have been saved to the files area, so don't worry about that. And if you notice, even though I just deleted that message, I do have the option as that member to undo the deletion of it, so that's kind of cool. Then if I go to this one, let's go to this message here and the three dots, and let's try the edit option. The edit option lets me edit anything about this message. I could add more to it, I can bold it, I can delete the whole thing. So if you let me edit a message but you don't let me delete, I kind of have a way around it, right? But just so you know, those are the two options that you have for your membership. Again, to really encourage flexibility and maybe interaction or engagement within your team, you might want to be encouraging your members of the team to be able to add a message and then change it if they need to, or get rid of it if they feel like, oh, that wasn't the right thing to put down here. All right, so there you have it, member permissions. Consider these wisely. You might turn a lot of these permissions off, especially when people are new to a team environment. But as people get used to the team environment and want to interact more and make some changes, then you might decide that you can open them up a little bit more. But as the owner of the team, you have that ability to change the permissions. So have fun, make some changes. Thanks. Bye-bye.